I'm an astronomer, and so my professional life is about looking at the universe and trying to make sense of it. But something that does impact my life is that I've always been, as a woman, in the kind of minority of people doing what I do. And even though it's not held me back, it's something that I'm really aware of. And so when I was writing this book, I was particularly compelled by reading the stories of these women astronomers in the past who've made these great discoveries. And I found it so compelling partly because many of their discoveries were extremely important, and yet people have not, I think, heard about these women as much as they should have. But I also found them compelling because I wanted to know about their lives. I wanted to know how they'd handled raising children and being a scientist, and how they'd handled being in a minority. And so that was one of the things I found most enjoyable about researching them and discovering what amazing things they'd done. Henrietta Swan Leavitt is one of the great figures in astronomy who hasn't got the fame she deserves, actually. She was doing astronomy at the turn of the last century, and she was part of this amazing group of women called the Harvard Computers, who were women astronomers based at Harvard College Observatory around 1900. And they were brought together by the astronomer Edward Pickering, who wanted to have a group of people studying and interpreting pictures of the stars. And he brought in a group of women to do the quite painstaking work of classifying stars, of measuring their brightness, their colors, and unfortunately being paid quite a lot less than their male colleagues, and not being allowed to operate telescopes. Only the men were allowed to operate telescopes at the time. So Henrietta Swan Leavitt joined this group. She'd previously studied astronomy at Radcliffe College, which was the women's college attached to Harvard University, which at the time didn't accept women. She'd come back to astronomy after an illness that had left her deaf. She was tasked with studying stars that vary in brightness. They get dimmer and brighter with time. And so she had the job of looking at photographic images, photographic plates of stars taken at different times and seeing how they changed. And she identified in particular a group of stars that were of a particular sort. They were called Cepheid variable stars. They're stars that pulsate. They get bigger and smaller over time, and their brightness changes as they get bigger and smaller. So they pulse at a rate of days or weeks or months. And Henrietta Swan Leavitt figured out this particular pattern. She figured out that the duration of their pulse was directly connected to how intrinsically bright they are. A star that was particularly bright would take longer to pulse, weeks or months, compared to a faint star that took just days. What she discovered was a thing that we now call a standard candle. It's something that you are able to know the brightness of. This pattern, which is now known as Leavitt's law, but for a long time in the past didn't actually carry her name, this proved to be the key to unlocking the whole size of the universe, and as it turned out, the age of the universe as well.